Hello for Friday, July 11th, and aren't we glad we have a weekend upon us? Look at the market here since here's July starting here with the lows all around 11,100 area, a little bit higher, a little bit lower. Now the highs around 11,400. Just can't seem to get out of the range. Well, we identified a while back, you know, a few biotechs are moving. Then we looked at 250 some biotechs or biotech related stocks and selected several of them, and they just keep on going ahead. You know, and they're kind of speculative because the FDA can anytime come out with some bad news on one. Of course, they could come out with good news also. But we found the ones that are moving and realized that money is flowing into those stocks. You know, this is like identifying, well, whatever sector. And we got this one spot on. Look at this Amgen, how it just keeps on making new highs, a little bit at a time. Like, you know, it only got back up to the high from yesterday, and the volume is decreasing. So you do have to have some stops because it's pretty steep up here, and it could pull back. But isn't that one nice? That continued. Also, we've got, well, here, this one, if we can just change this just one second. There we go. OSI Pharmaceuticals as well. Look at this. We pointed out that this also had the golden cross. And you know, when we see that, like right in here, when that happens quite often, that's quite bullish. And of course, since the others like Amgen were going, we figured this one's like a really pretty safe bet to hold on to this one for a while. And this one's had some nice gains as well. And so did Amgen. Now this one had its golden cross back in May, and you can see good gains. It came back. It tested the 50-day actually one time and then another time, dipping below it, but then came powering ahead. Quite often when they do that, they'll do a repeat. So they power ahead, consolidate a few days, and then look at that again on Thursday. Nice moves there. So going back to the indexes, here we've got the Dow. You see it made this little double kind of bottomish in this area. And this was the first one was right when RSI was below 30, that a buy point. And then, of course, the stochastics moved above 20. And then it happened later in the afternoon when it made a double bottom. It also went below 20, and then a lot of people bought when it comes back above that. So now we're looking, need to have, first off, a breakout above. Look how this is again parallel. This line and this line and this line, they're all kind of parallel. So when this breaks out again above this area, which is, look, this is covered up, it's around 11,250. If it gets up in this area and looks like we've got some movement on your 5-minute chart, that may be a buy point up to 11,337. On the downside, right now it doesn't look, there's a good, not a good entry other than breaking below the low as far as I see it at the moment. Maybe you'll see it on a 5-minute chart. On the SPX, similar with a little double bottom. I don't have this line drawn, but you could draw a parallel line here. I don't like that setup so well. You could do it, but it's only about 6-7 points up here. I'd prefer to wait for it, although some traders I'm sure will come in right in this area around 1,260, and then 1,268. If it breaks out at 269, if it breaks out above this line, that's the 200 period also, that may go. And again, the short is below the low of the day. And on the Russell, this kind of, you know, the Russell particularly loves these double bottoms. It loves technicals. It just loves them. And we like to trade it as well. And so now it's, if it breaks above this area around 2 or 675, it could be a buy, but you may want to wait till 678 until it breaks above the 200 period, and we want to see some good strong action there as well. And on the downside, below this 661 area is where we'd be looking to go short there. Okay, additions to the watch list, we've got ups and downs. Now this one, ELN, actually looked at it yesterday, but decided to put it on the list today, and then we showed it in the chat room because it broke out above the 36.08 and did run quite nicely up to 37.50. It ran over a buck, so it ran nicely, but the volume increased, and since it pulled back, I think it could be a continuation play. This one, a good move up, good consolidation, so it doesn't look like it's broken down. It looks like it could consolidate. If you kept your stop in this area, just watch for ELN, a possible continuation play there. PTEC, this is one that isn't fantastic. It had a big move up here. Was that, maybe that was the Russell 2000 day. We have to count back and see if that was a week ago Friday. But still, it's been consolidating in this area between 10 and 1180. It hit 1180, 1173, 1175. It ran above it on Thursday, but the volume, tiny, really 142,000. We want to see like a couple, 200,000 or 300,000. But if it can break above that again, either, let's see what we put it down on the, I can't find it. So, oh, I can find it. I think above this 1180, 1190, or above the 12,800, I mean the $12.08, once it gets above that 200 day, may be the place that would be interesting on PTEC. Okay, next up we've got F5 networks. Now, if tech does haven't come back, look, this hit this first little buy point actually in the daytime. We showed this in the chat room as well, because this would have been, in fact, we wrote it down that this would be for the for more adventure, for the for a bit more adventure, you could buy it in this area instead of waiting for the breakout. But if we do have return of good volume, if this can move up. It got as high as 32.72, so if it can break above 32.72 FFIV, especially if tech's moving, this looks like a possibility. Now on the short side, we've got NYT. This is one we showed in the video yesterday, but we did not put it on the list because we thought it needs another day. It did break, and so it's just as well that we didn't have it, because we had it at 65 and look, it broke what, about 20 cents, and then came back and closed right in that area. We figured it'd be nicer if it could consolidate a couple days. It didn't do that. We'd say though, again, if it could break below that 60 area or 1340, that low of the day, NYT, it may be a continuation short. Now this has been dropping a lot, so it really could use a bounce first, but we present it. And you can do what you like with it. New York Times, you might read up on what's going on with them. Now we've got WHQ, Energy Services, and this would be a logical point to bounce. This low we looked up on the historic chart. I got to look up and see where it was. 90.75. It gapped up, and the low of that day was 90.75 right here. So this would be support. From here on up is support. Now it was low volume on Thursday, as you can see on this bounce. So it could be played as a bounce, but I wouldn't be interested unless it had really strong volume. So sometimes if the market was good, that we would count on this support being holding. But if it doesn't, at any rate, set your alerts. If it gets below 90.75, I think it could come down at least to the 88.48 to the 50 day, and if that breaks, then it'll come down and fill that gap. But these breakaway gaps shouldn't fill, but halfway filled is very common, and that would bring it right down to the 50 day, which would make it a, you know, a good 3 point trade there. Okay, next up we've got Adobe Systems, and Adobe has actually it could be played on the long side. If volume picks up and it can move back above the 50 day, this would be about 40.50, I would call it. Then I think you could play that alongside. A breakdown, though, however, would be back below 38.20. Looks like a short on Adobe Systems. Okay, we've then got not that. We've then got KSS. This looks much more like a short. Look at this huge volume that it had on Thursday. But this one would have to also, it'd be nicer if they consolidate. But look, in the past, this dropped like 5, 6, 7, 8 days in a row. So if this drops below the 38.86, I think that's a possibility of a short right there. And lastly, we've got a gold stock, and that is, once again, we've got the little, all of our charts didn't size up. That's a little better. Okay, so ABX, Barrick Gold, and you can see it did break above the 47, got as high as 47.60. But I think if the volume's good, if gold starts to pick up again, maybe this will shoot on through here. Now remember, gold, so you can see how this does. Quite often it leaves these long wick tops and pulls back. So this may be, depending on the way you trade, it's volatile. In other words, quite often it'll come running up. So take some profits, and then when it comes back, you might want to add to it. This does have a golden cross, and that's a good sign, but that doesn't mean that gold's going to continue. But ABX above about 47, I think it's worth a trade. So those are the additions for the watch list. A weekend's coming up, a summer weekend. We'll have a newsletter out. If you're not signed up on the homepage, there's a sign up there that's free. And we'll put that out on the weekend. So hope you have just a really great summer weekend. And we'll be back again on Monday with some new ideas. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.